at least almonds, but there's two types of bhakti. The first, we should understand, the eternal residents of Goloka Vrindavan, they're called Ragatmik. For example, those who serve Krishna and Sakiras, like Subal, Sridham, and Ranamundo. Those who serve in Vatsaliras, like Madhyasoda and Nandabhava. And those who serve in Madhuras, like the Gopis, they're called Ragatmik. Therefore, the sadhak, hearing Harikatha pertaining to one of these rasas, then he develops a greed. I want to also perform seva like that. Therefore, he is called Raganuga because he follows anuk that rag of the Ragatmik devotees. Therefore, rag also means attachment. He is attached to the performing that type of seva. Therefore, the Brijvasis always have that anurag, that deep attachment to Krishna in any circumstance. Therefore, Krishna cannot break that relationship with them. Therefore, just like when a leaf sprouts, the outside of the leaf is a little rough, but the inside section of the leaf is very smooth. Therefore, because their attraction to Krishna flows in a very natural way, it is compared to the inside of the leaf being very shika or soft. And Vaidhi Bhakti represents the downside of the leaf, the outside portion of the leaf, because it's a little hard. Therefore, when we hear, even if one is in Varnashram, but he is not performing bhajan to Krishna, then he goes to Gaurav, he goes to hell. We hear that even if one completely and perfectly follows Varnashram Dharma, he fulfills all his material responsibilities towards his mother and father, his country, his society, his vana and ashram. But if he does not perform bhajan of Krishna, then he also descends to the hellish planets. Therefore, by hearing this type of katha, the bhakti will sprout. And that bhakti is called Vaidhi Bhakti because it's impelled of fear of the scriptures. In Vaidhi Bhakti, one is not performing seva of Krishna due to love and affection for Krishna. Rather, being afraid of the ocean of repeated birth and death and the troubles caused by Maya, he performs bhajan. Therefore, in Vaidhi Bhakti, there is no thick relationship like in Raghunatha Bhakti. Therefore, it represents the lower side of the leaf, because in that sense it is inferior or subordinate. Therefore, Vaidhi Bhakti is subordinate to Raghunatha Bhakti. Raghunatha Bhakti has some special quality that it gallops, it jumps on the head of everything. Sri Rupa Goswami gave 64 limbs of bhakti, but if Raghunatha Bhakti being of a superior nature, if some angas of devotion are left out, there is no fault. But Vaidhi Bhakti, you have to follow all 64 limbs. Therefore, which limbs can be left out, we will discuss later. Both sides of the leaf are important, and in one sense, both sides of the leaf are of equal value. And both types of bhakti, Vaidhi Bhakti and Raghunatha, both give the true results of Kleshagni and Suvada. Kleshagni means destruction of obstacles, Suvada means the attainment of all auspiciousness. Therefore, in simple language, Rag means ruchi, taste, attraction towards Krishna. And then the absence of that attraction or rag, in the absence of that rag, that bhakti will be called Vaidhi Bhakti. That greed may arise by having darshan of the deity or by hearing the Srimad Bhagavatam. Therefore, Srimad Sukadeva Goswami has said, Tasmat Bharata Sarvatma. O Bharat, the Jivatma, because of attachment to material things, he becomes afraid of descending to the hellish planets. Therefore, for that reason, he takes to the name of Bhagavan and hears Hari Katha.
आत्मतत्व के भूले जाओ, कृष्ण के भूले जाओ, अनित्य वस्तुओं को नित्य समझना, स्त्री पुत्र परिवार घर इत्यादि को नित्य समझना, अपवित्र को पवित्र समझना, दुखों को सुख समझना। तेन के स्त्री पुत्र विषय वैभव नश्वर वस्तुओं को नित्य समझना। हाड़ मांस रक्त अस्थि बलमूत्र आदि से परिपूर्ण इस अपवित्र शरीर को परम पवित्र और मैं समझना। इन शुद्ध विषय सुखों के परिणाम स्वरूप जन्म मरण आदि नरक दुख भोग होते हैं। यही सब लिखे बोले अविद्या का अस्मिता। दृष्टि शक्ति दर्शन शक्ति की एकात्मता का ज्ञान अस्मिता तथा मैं और मेरा आमी और हमारा शरीर के आमी शरीर संबंधी वस्तु सुधुली के हमारा यही के मोह यही के बोले अस्मिता। राग राग मैंने विषय प्रति के अनुराग आसे कहा के बोले राग। सुख प्राप्ति दुख निवृत्ति के उपायों की कामना को राग करते अथवा अभिलषित वस्तु को पाकर पुनः अधिक पाने की कामना को राग। विषयों में आसक्त और उसी के लिए प्रयास द्वेष सुख और दुख के कारण के प्रति व्यक्ति का नाम द्वेष। सुख या दुख जिसके कारण जिसके प्रति व्यक्ति का नाम द्वेष है। अभिनिवेश अनुकूल विषय प्राप्त करने के आधार से शरीर में अशक्त और मृत्यु के भय से भयभीत होने का नाम अभिनिवेश। पुनः प्रारब्ध अप्रारब्ध रूह भी एक चार प्रकार आरोप प्रारब्ध पाप जन्मे थे अमिता पाप इत्यादि या अथवा पुण्य परिचित जहाँ फल हो करना जन्मे यही सही एक प्रारब्ध अर्थात तार मध्य अंकुर उत्पन्न हुए थे तार के भोग करते हैं। आज एक दुनिया भी भय है कोटि कोटि जन्मे जमा संचित पाप छोटा के बोले अप्रारब्ध पाप अनूल अथवा सुख पाप जो पाप का बीज रूप धारण करके आने वाले समय में फूटेंगे। अप्रारब्ध कर्म की समष्टि के रूप में ये अवस्थित रहते अपनी पाप वासना में वासना के रूप में रहते हैं और प्रारब्ध की पृष्ठभूमि है। ये सभी क्लेश हैं, ये सभी क्लेश भक्ति के द्वारा दूर हो जाते। ये क्लेश अग्नि है अपराध फलम पापम कृतम बीज फलम रूपम क्रमेण एव प्रतिलिप्यते विष्णु भक्ति होता। जहां तक आत्मा अर्थात जो शरीर मन प्राण आदि सभी कृष्ण भक्ति के निविष्ट तहां दे प्रारब्ध अप्रारब्ध पूर्व पाप भी फलुन्नु सब कुछ भक्ति द्वारा मायापाधीरा मुक्ति एकदम चरुसीमा दे पहुंची छे एमन अवस्था में तहां दे प्रारब्ध कर्म भोग करते हैं। वैष्णव नमाभास होने पर प्रारब्ध कर्म करके
देखो क्लेशाग्नि इन क्लेशाग्नि अविद्या और इग्नोरेंस इज कंप्लीटली डिस्ट्रॉयड। What is avidya? Avidya means forgetfulness of the true self and forgetfulness of Bhagavan. Accepting what is temporary to be eternal, accepting which is suffering to think, to accepting that which is temporary to accept as being eternal, that which is suffering to accept as being full of happiness, that which is pure to accept, that which is impure to accept as pure. This is all called avidya, ignorance. It pertains to the body. Therefore, this avidya has six components. Avidya, ignorance. Asmita, illusion. Thinking constantly, I am mine. Forgetfulness. Thinking, I am this body and what pertains to this body belongs to me is for my enjoyment. Raag. Raag means attachment towards the objects of the senses. Dvesh. Upon not attaining that happiness, one feels detachment, disgust, envy. Abhinivesh. Absorption in falsity and fear of death. These six components of avidya. Also, we should see there are four sub-compartments. Parabdha, aparabdha, kurva, and bij. Parabdha, that karma which I am experiencing now in this present body. Aparabdha karma, what I will experience in the future due to my past activities. Bij means the seed of pious or sinful desires which have not sprouted, which are still in an unmanifest state, that also refers to aparabdha karma. And finally, when that seed sprouts in the form of vasana, desire, which is now manifest in this body, therefore it refers to parabdha karma, these four are also destroyed at this stage. By engaging the body, mind, senses, intelligence, and all the objects in our possession in bhakti, then the attachment to all these things are completely destroyed. Avidya is uprooted. Therefore, even the mayavadis, which strive very hard for mukti, and they consider that to be the topmost achievement, even those mayavadis, those liberated souls, have to taste parabdha karma, this body. But the devotees, even upon achieving namavasivan, they do not have to taste that parabdha karma.
यद्यपि विषादादि रुचिकर होते न निरस होने पर तथापि वो साधारण भाव से जाना उचित जत रूप में पाप ताप आज भक्ति प्रारंभ के एक विषय इज नॉट रेस्टफुल बट वी शुड नो इन फ्री that in the beginning of bhakti, all kinds of paap, sin, everything goes away. Even prarabdha karma. Rupa Goswami has told that parabrahma sakshat kriti nishchayati vinasham ayati vinana bhogai अपैतुना विस्मृणे तत्व प्रारब्ध कर्मों की प्रयोग बिना जाते इवन प्रारब्ध कर्म विच मायावादी अद्वैतवादी दे विल हैव टू टेस्ट इट श्योरली बट भक्त एंड नेवर टेस्ट इट भक्ति इज हाउ ग्लोरियस ब्यूटीफुल এখন আমরা প্রথমে এখানে যেতে পারি মানসিক গঙ্গা হয়ে এসেছে গো বিথ পান্ডাজি মানসিক গঙ্গা অ্যান্ড গিভ প্রতীক দেয়ার অ্যান্ড দেন রিটার্ন ব্যাক অ্যান্ড বিয়ার ইন ফ্রন্ট অফ ঠাকুরজি ইন ইচ হাউস রুম আপসাইড হিয়ার দেয়ার এভরি where you should be of the
people. Are you sir? Now we will announce the names of the devotees who have received initiation. Very briefly, please remain seated, everyone. Madhura Madhonika Agodya from England.
নিজের কাছে পাসপোর্ট টাকা পয়সা রাখবেন না, তাকে পকেট মারি খুব জোর হবে। You should not take your passports and other things valuable. No ornament, no money in your bag. Otherwise today, notorious pickpockets are everywhere. So, you should be careful.
Hare Krishna. Bangali Bhaktaranar jonno bolchi, apnara ekhane ratre peshab korben na. Ar Maharajer ghore pishone okhane dhuke apnara paikhana korchen, apnara paikhana korben na. আপনাদের পায়খানার জন্য ওখানে ব্যবস্থা আছে এবং এই দিকে ব্যবস্থা আছে। যারা এখানে নিচে বেসমেন্টে আসেন, এখানে রাত্রিটা আপনারা পেশাব করেন, আমাদের যার প্রধান আপনারা মেজাজ দেখিয়েছেন, এখানে কেউ পেশাব করবেন না, বলতে পায়খানা করবেন না। পায়খানা কেবল পায়খানার মধ্যে গিয়েই পায়খানা করবেন, ওখানে প্রচুর পায়খানা আছে, এই দিকেও প্রচুর পায়খানা আছে।
হরে কৃষ্ণ মোহিনী দেবী দাসী Stephanie of Vindadadu from France sang Gita Devi Dasi. Mahamaya Dasi from West Bengal sang Mahamaya Dasi. Gita Radhika Devi Dasi, Gita Devi Dasi from Bangalore.
Hare Krishna.
Tomorrow. Hare Krishna.